friends, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding for a public policy roadmap written by C. Rajkumar. From examination point of view, it will help you in General Studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 4. And this editorial is specifically for the public administration optional students. Now this editorial has linked two things. It has linked the business stability and the issue of public policy. So we need to understand of what is the linkage between the public policy and the business. Before we understand the linkage, we need to understand what is public policy. Public policy is a manifestation of the desire of what the government wants to do. Public policy is a holistic document. It is an encompassive document which mentions about the direction into which the rules, the regulations, the programs, and the plans about a particular sector will be launched or will be implemented. So it is a big guiding force behind the plans, the programs, the activities and the actions and the minuscule decision making that will be taking place in a particular sector. It is a guiding force. Now, how this public policy is linked to the business? See, public policy is a very encompassive thing. It's a very holistic thing. It provides stability to governance. It provides sustenance to governance. And these two things, the sustainability of the governance and the stability of the governance, are two vital elements for the prosperity of business. Now, why India's ranking has fallen in global competitiveness index? See, India is one such country in which the shelf life of a policy is very less. We change our policies every now and then. There is no research done in the public policies. The public policies, they are designed by the political leaders because they have the responsibility. We have given them the responsibility through the elections. We are having a parliamentary form of government in which the parliament, the government has the authority to run our country. But public policy is a very serious domain. If we will infuse too much of politics in this domain of public policy, it will have very bad repercussions. It will have very bad outcomes. Outcomes in the terms of the people will not have a faith in the credibility of our nation. There will be a loss of credibility. There will be a withering of credibility. It will go for a toss. So in order to provide credibility to the people who are almost ready to invest in our country, we need to create good policies. Now, how these good policies can be created? How can we design a holistic and encompassive public policy? Public policy, it involves legislature, it involves executives, it involves peoples, it involves NGOs, it involves research, it involves experts, etc. And apart from these things, it also involves a lot of permutations and combinations. What needs to be done? How it has to be done? For how long this policy action will be able to yield the result? For how long we will be able to sustain these policy, this particular policy? These are the questions that needs to be answered before a policy document is finalized. In public administration, we read a thinker, Herbert Simon, which has put forward his theory of rational decision making, of how we need to quantify the various choices. And after the quantification of the infinite choices is done, we need to arrive at a particular policy. We need to arrive at a particular decision. See, we cannot have the infinite choices from which we should be choosing up a final decision. If you want to buy a shirt, it is not like that you will look for the each and every shirt that is present in the showrooms, the online stores, etc. You will look for a sample, and out of the sample you will choose the one that will be more satisfying. This is bounded rationality model. But what is happening in the political realm with respect to this public policy is we are trying to generate policies without being rational and without even being in the sphere of bounded rationality. And because of that, the shelf life of the policies is less. Research is not taken care of. Such a situation will create a very debilitating kind of atmosphere. Education ki policy har 6 mahine ke baad change ho jata hai. Kis cheez ke upar hame focus karna hai? Energy policy pata nahi hai kahan pe hame focus karna hai, kyunki holistic and encompassive nahi dekhte. Now why, another big reason of why India has not been able to create good policies. India mein koi bhi aisa policy nahi hai jisko dekhe kahe ki yes, it is like a role model and this policy should be implemented in other countries also. Koi bhi sphere le lijiye, education sphere, worst policies we are having. Rural development, worst policies we are having. Now what is the cause of why we have failed to generate the effective economic and efficient public policies? The big cause is the bureaucracy. Bureaucracy is indifferent, it is callous, it is a status quoist, it is a slow, it is a positive institution that believes in pauses, that believes in red taping each and everything. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to my channel. Name of my channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you are interested in buying my video classes on entire civil services preparation. And for availing further information, you can visit my website EIASmentors.com and brainyki.com. And you can click on the like button, you can share this video, you can comment on this video. And so this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.